I'm Alex Scott, and today I'm going inside an open-plan lab built by Shell, the energy and chemicals company, here in Amsterdam. Open-plan buildings and labs are becoming the norm, with many pharma and chemical companies looking to have their scientists work together rather than separately in discrete rooms and buildings.
On that end, we have experiments being done, and on that end, we have offices. And in the middle, you see the connecting bridges with the strategic meeting points.
That's corporate speak for coffee bars. About 900 scientists and engineers in diverse disciplines work here. Shell thinks that putting them into proximity, chatting over coffee in the glass atrium, will lead to productive idea sharing. Some of that is already happening.
Some time ago, when standing on one of the bridges across the atrium, I saw a face I hadn't seen in a long time, actually somebody I knew from the days back in university. So we sort of waved at each other and decided to have a coffee. So by a chance meeting, we discovered that we actually had a lot of technology in common.
Despite successes, not everyone thinks that the transition's been perfect.
There are pros and cons for working in an open office plan.
For example, Shell has had to ensure that noisy people are grouped together so that they don't disturb quieter workers. Site manager Calis' hunch is that even with such systems in place, scientists working in the building are happier and more productive. And ultimately, that means more chance discussions that could lead to great science. I'm Alex Scott, reporting for Chemical and Engineering News.